Good evening, everyone. I'm Hank Buckets here for SGU Sports Network and our coverage of the Western Conference Finals between the Los Angeles Lakers and the Los Angeles Clippers. Tonight is Game 5, and we are tied at 2 games apiece. This is a pivotal game. LeBron James and the Lakers won Game 1. The Clippers bounced back, winning 2 in a row before the Lakers tied it up at 2 apiece. Both teams call Staples Center their home, but as for tonight, it's officially a Lakers home game. Earlier today in Eastern Conference Finals action, the Milwaukee Bucks eliminated the Boston Celtics in Game 5, winning the series 4-1. The Bucks will now sit back and await their opponent in the NBA Finals. They will have an eye on this game tonight to see who they might possibly be playing. So with that, we prepare to send it out to Staples Center and get Game 5 underway. Will it be LeBron James and Anthony Davis that get the upper hand, or will Kawhi Leonard and Paul George be waiting to ambush them? It's all straight ahead in Game 5 of the Western Conference Finals.
Tied 2-2 here in the Western Conference Finals battle. Now all eyes set on Game 5. 2K Sports presents the playoffs of the NBA. With Greg Anthony and Chris Webber, this is Kevin Harlan. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. DA, it's all yours.
Well, LeBron James is closing in on the top 3 all-time list in scoring. LeBron said, it's an honor, but he added, scoring has never been on my list of goals. Facilitating, rebounding, defending, getting block shots and things of that nature, always ranked above that. Kevin, he has filled up the box score for a long time.
He can impact the game in so many ways. DA, thank you. Here are the 5 for the Clippers. Paul George is out there with Patrick Beverley. Then it's Ivica Zubac. Then it's Marcus Morris. And it's Leonard in at the 3 spot. And for the Lakers, LeBron and Bradley are the guards. Green and Davis in at the forward positions. And it's McGee in at the center, filling out the middle. Tip-off goes to the Clippers. Davis against Leonard. Right through the D for the layup.
And he moves so well. When Leonard drives the lane, it's pretty much a guaranteed bucket. Terrific body control, and he plays with the ultimate force.
Now here is McGee. To the middle. Got a piece of it. And so it looks like the Lakers will retain possession here.
And he made the right read on that play, but just couldn't secure the steal.
And you can tell he feels he should have had it still. The hustle was impressive.
It's Bradley on the wing, defended by Beverley. 5 on the clock. Bradley can't get it to go. George with the ball. And McGee picks him up defensively. George, no good. And so James will bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. They easily took Thursday's game.
And really showed their depth when they needed it most. On the road, having to manufacture points.
The bench did exactly what they needed to do. Without their production, who knows if they win that game.
Now here's Leonard. And he dunks it right over JaVale McGee. Holy cow.
And the feed from George couldn't be better. The timing, the placement, everything about that dish was pinpoint.
Here's LeBron. The shot, no good. Excellent D there from George. The Clippers have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. And it's blocked by Bradley.
Such a long wingspan, and that helps Bradley make up for his lack of height. He's a disruptive defensive presence.
Now here's James. And the rejection by Zubac. And the pass to Davis. Bucket is good.
I mean, the passing genius of LeBron coming to the surface. I mean, a look that only a few players in the league can make.
Leonard against Davis. A second chance effort, and Davis sends it back. George against LeBron. He nails it, and we're tied up.
The if you're the defense, what can you do? James is too strong, too focused when he's finishing.
Here's Leonard. Another miss by Leonard.
They know they can't give him that shot. The D's are over it, not even giving him an inch of space.
Davis, the pass to James. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. McGee's shot is off.
It's a very aggressive defense to prevent the easy lay-in.
Beverly dishes to Leonard. From deep, George, no good.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space, but the defender was right there.
Oh, man, did you see him close that gap? What a great job. He made the shooter feel uncomfortable.
Now here's Leonard, following the miss by Anthony Davis. Leonard inside. James with some nice D.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim. His field goal percentage has dipped this quarter. I mean, his movement has to be better. He has to find the open spots on the floor.
It's Bradley on the wing, covered by Morris. Poked away, stolen by Beverly. Feeds it to Leonard. And two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the content. It's going to be on Avery Bradley.
And the soft-spoken Leonard is now an elite talent in this league, an athletic forward who leads by example.
The Clippers shooting their first free throws here for the night. That free throw good from Leonard. So he hits both.
Well, his free throw shooting is something they never need to worry about. He doesn't even know how to go through a cold streak.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here. And so James will bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
That is what LeBron does. No one challenges the heart of the defense more than him. Impossible to stop him when he gets that.
And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. That one on Davis.
Yeah, the defender all over.
The Clippers have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line. Good on that one. And he's good on the second. The Lakers trail. James outside. And James throws it down.
James is just remarkable, showing no remorse when he's attacking the rim.
James has gone 3 of 6 shooting from the field, 50% so far. Here's Leonard. Rebound the Lakers. It's Bradley on the wing, covered by Morris. And Bradley gets it to go.
Oh, you see Bradley's toughness, able to finish through the contact.
Clippers trail by 3. And Beverly kicks to Morris. George against James. Here's Zubac. McGee with the block.
Well, this is McGee's role. He's out here to defend and to stifle shooters whenever he can.
James looking around. Leonard against Green. 6 to shoot. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. And here's Bradley from three. An absolute bomb from three-point range. Bradley's got five.
And that's where he's most comfortable. Bradley crafting his game to excel in the catch and shoot.
Here's George. And again, unable to change momentum here.
If his performance this quarter is any indication, I don't think he's the one who's going to let them out of the hole.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Back to Beverly. Fires for three. George, no good.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Oh, man, awful display from him so far. But you know he's going to keep working to try to turn it around.
Now, here's Zubats. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. And Beverly kicks to Leonard. Clippers moving the ball around. From deep three-point range, rebounded by the Lakers. McGee's got his seventh rebound here tonight.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Pass to Davis. No good on that one. 80 that time from Leonard. Beverly against Bradley. Beverly in the pass to George. Over LeBron. George with the bucket.
About time he got one to fall there. Before that, six straight misses to start this one.
Lakers leading by four. James outside. McGee trying to break free. James with the bucket. James has got 8 points.
Such a consistent night for him from the field. Whenever they've needed him, he's been their safety valve.
Here's Leonard. Here's Zubats. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points.
I wouldn't want to be the guy who has to keep him off the boards. He is a beast on the offensive lines.
Bradley finds James. Trying to get open as Davis gets it to drop, and now he's shooting at a 5-for-8 clip.
Some players might wear down during this kind of run. He's only been strong.
Pass to Zubats. James against George. Rebounded by the Lakers. McGee's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots out there.
Now here's James. 10 points for him. Green taking his time here. Back to LeBron. Paul George with the steal. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
Very aggressive in terms of looking for his shot. 9 attempts already, but only able to knock down 2.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Harrell, he's checked in for Zubats. Landry Shamet comes in for Marcus Morris. And it's Williams in for Patrick Beverley. That free throw good from George. Lakers leading by 3. Bradley with the ball. 5 points in the game. James misses. Outside Williams. Pass to Shamet. Now here's George. Outside Williams. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. Lakers shooting at around 44% in the early goings here. James dishes to Bradley. LeBron against Williams. And LeBron with the basket, the assist by Bradley. And 12 points for LeBron.
He's pulling out all the tricks this quarter. They can't figure out how to stop him.
And George kicks to Harrell. Now the pass to Shamet. Outside, George. Over Green. The 9-footer's on the mark. And it's 7 points for Paul George.
And if you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
Bradley finds James. And James throws it down.
Oh, nice look by Bradley, moving it to the open man.
Clippers trail by five. Passes it to Leonard. He can't get that one to fall. And the Lakers take it the other way.
His offense has been non-existent tonight. It's really hurting him.
Davis, the pass to LeBron. Over George. And it's James missing.
His interior scoring is one of the things that drives their offense. Don't expect him to miss many throws.
Outside Williams. Pass to Leonard. He kicks it to George. Six on the shot clock. Over LeBron. And it's George missing.
I don't know if it's been the main factor, but this off night has definitely been one factor here.
Pass to James. Back to Bradley. Outside Green. The pass to Davis. Lays it up off the glass. Now it's a 7-point Laker lead.
If there's a list of the best inside scorers in the NBA, Davis has got to be right at the top. When he gets his hands on the ball down low, you might as well just count it.
And so it's LeBron James making things happen for the Los Angeles Lakers. He totaled 14 points in the quarter. He's given them all the offense they need right now. Right back after this break.
After one quarter, we've got a good one brewing here. The Lakers in the lead, and LeBron looking strong with 14 first quarter points. Plenty of time left for Kawhi and company to scratch back into this one and possibly take the lead. Just a reminder for those of us just joining us, the Milwaukee Bucks have finished off the Boston Celtics in 5 games and await the winner of the Western Conference Finals. No matter who represents the West, we are going to have one entertaining NBA Finals. Let's rejoin for the second quarter of this pivotal Game 5.
Paul George had that nasty broken leg back in 2014. He describes what inspired him to come back even stronger.
My inspiration really came from my mother. You know, her dealing with stroke, her dealing with really being down and out. You know, I saw her fight back. That was enough for me. In my darkest days, I knew it was nothing to what my mom went through, and she came out perfectly fine, so.
Well, what a story. George worked hard to get back and is not disappointed in his return.
You know, recovering from a devastating injury is never easy, but George's perspective and commitment helped him to overcome it.
What an atmosphere in here as we return to the action of the Western Conference Finals. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Lakers here so far, guys.
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Yeah, they really got after it. I mean, they made life extremely difficult for the shooters, which is why they hold this lead.
At the two and the three, it's Bradley and Green. Markieff Morris is out there with Davis, and it's Rondo in at the one. That's who's in the game for the Lakers.
Man, when the ball's in his hands, that's as high percentage as it gets. It's just a fluke miss.
Rondo against Williams. Passes it to Leonard. The basket is good off the assist from Williams. That's 12 points for Leonard.
Oh, no hesitation to get it to the rim. He uses his height advantage to convert the easy.
Pass to Green. And here is Davis. That's good, and it's his fourth basket of the game. He's a strong 4-for-6.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
To Shamet. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Morris outside. Here's Bradley. That one, no good. So the Clippers will take it the other way.
They haven't eaten them as much as I thought they would tonight.
Yeah, you see the athleticism George had on that dunk. It's so quick and explosive. Gets to the rim in an instant.
Rondo against Leonard. Outside for Davis. On the wing, Green. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, he's checked in for the Lakers. The Clippers have gone three of their first five shots to drop here in the second quarter. Williams against Bradley. Knocked away. Leonard kicks to Shamet. Back to Leonard. The tray. Morris with the rebound.
He hit one three in the first, but the well has been totally dry for him in the second.
Pass to Rondo. Back to Morris. It's Bradley on the wing. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. That's on Lou Williams.
But the defensive specialist, Bradley, now a veteran, he's proven to be a guy who can contribute well as a starter or a bench reserve.
That free throw, no good. No good on the second free throw. And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Clippers. Defense has only allowed 4 points in the quarter. There's the pass to Leonard. Over Davis. And they're unable to get the time basket there. The Lakers in the lead. Rondo passes to Caldwell Pope. Passes to Bradley. Morris dishes to Bradley. To stop the drought. Trying to get open is Davis, and it's Bradley laying it in. Bradley's got seven.
A combo guard with fantastic handles. It's clear Bradley enjoys ripping off these moves.
The three from George. Rebound the Lakers. Now here's Rondo. No points in the game yet for him. Kicks to Morris. Caldwell Pope feeling it out a bit. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
And Caldwell Pope just blows past defenders with his speed. Just a sensational finisher all around the bucket.
Williams with a clean look. And again, no good by the Clippers. Lakers leading by six. Caldwell Pope outside. Back to Rondo. Outside Bradley. Davis inside. He's covered by Shamet. And Davis can't get it to go. The Clippers have gone just 33% from the field in what's been a cold second quarter for them. Just 3 of 9. Pulls up for three. And it's Shamet with the rebound. Clippers trail by six. For three, Williams not going to fall.
Starting off slow, he misses his first three from the floor.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Rondo. And there's the call on Lou Williams. That'll be his second foul of the game. Jackson, he's checked in for Williams. Davis against Leonard. Outside Rondo. Down to five on the shot clock. He can't hit that time. Some solid defense there from Jackson. Shamet, the pass to Leonard. And that one is good. Leonard's got four this quarter.
And he's got the athleticism and strength to be a powerful presence inside. Leonard never afraid to get in and mix it up down low.
Bradley. 18 that time from Leonard.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
Well, that's why he's out there right now. In situations like this, he stands tall to prevent it.
the jump hook, and it's in there. Now just a two-point Laker lead. Lakers shooting reasonably well, 45%. Rondo dishes to Morris. To the paint, here's Bradley. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Bradley's got 9.
Look at Morris break down the defense on this play. If they leave one of these guys open, he's going to get it to him fast.
George with the ball. Now guarded by Caldwell Pope. Now, here's Shim. Tight defense on him. Takes a shot at the elbow. Tries again. Anthony Davis with the rebound. Davis has got 4 rebounds in this game. Caldwell Pope kicks to Rondo. Bradley passes to Davis. Now Morris. Back to Davis. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. It's Reggie Jackson with the rebound. Clippers trail by 4. Here's Leonard. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. He's got 18.
Yeah, that was the 3rd straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Davis dishes to Bradley. With some arc. Great D that time from Harrell.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
And for the Lakers, they're shooting 36% in the second quarter. They really haven't found their rhythm yet offensively here. Bradley deciding where to go with it. He feeds it to Morris. Over Jackson. And there's Morris. That's good on the assist by Bradley. Bradley's got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight. And here's George. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. 4-point game. The shot misses. And the Lakers will go the other way with it. Caldwell Pope for 3. They get it again. And Davis can't get it to go. The Clippers shooting 31%. Not looking sharp offensively, to say the least. Stolen by Caldwell Pope. Bradley kicks to Rondo. Pass to Caldwell Pope. Back to Rondo. Shamit with the steal. This is to George. Pass to Harrell. There's the feed to George. Harrell against Morris. Shot clock at 6. And the foul called on Markieff Morris. That is his 1st foul of the game. And the Lakers making a change here. James has checked in. And the Clippers decide to take their 1st timeout here.
And he's been trying to do it all himself, and it's not working. Instead of forcing shots, you got to focus on moving the ball and keeping everybody involved.
Feeds to Harrell. And it's LeBron James with the rebound. Lakers leading by 4. Rondo wide open. And again, the Lakers no good.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
You're right. He'd take that 10 out of 10 times. You're not going to miss many of those.
Oh, and he went for the 2-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there. Sure. Outside Bradley. Down low, Davis. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
The Lakers have not yet made a free throw in the game, 0 of 2 so far. First free throw is good. He's perfect from the line this time.
Oh, this is a big fella who has no problems at the foul line. I mean, very smooth touch on the stroke.
Outside, George. From the low block, count it. George has got 4 points in the quarter. The Lakers in the lead. Outside, Davis. The dish now to LeBron. Back to Davis. And finished off by Davis.
Oh, fellas, that was vicious. Two-hand monster slam.
Guys, I don't think there was anyone who could have stopped him on that one. Jackson deciding where to go with it. Here's Leonard. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. Jackson against Rondo. Morris outside. Here's Davis. Shoots over Leonard. And that one's good by Davis. Now it's a six-point Laker lead.
As dangerous as he is inside, Davis gives opponents nightmares when he's able to get to the mid-range. He's very reliable when he steps back and takes the jump shot. And one step ahead of the defense with that solid screen.
And then, Greg, the monster dunk to finish it off.
Well, come on, guys. Someone has to rotate over. Defensively, that's just poor communication.
5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. And it's Harrell at the elbow. Knocked loose.
And no need to rush this. Let the clock run down.
Yeah. No need to give the ball back here. You want to close this quarter with momentum.
Here's LeBron. He got it up. Drains the three, and yes, he'll go to the line for one more. It's on Kawhi Leonard. Lakers shooting their fifth free throw of the game here. And the Clippers making a change here.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
Free throw good, James.
In many ways, he feels like he's playing his best ball right now when you talk about LeBron James.
And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. They have made it very tough to get a shot off against them. Their defense has been stifling. And now time for halftime, so we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
At the half, we have Lakers 45, Clippers 37. It's an 8-point lead for the Lakers as they go to the locker room for halftime. LeBron's got to be happy with the performance, but there's a lot of work left to do. One team that's already done a ton of work is the Milwaukee Bucks. They've advanced to the NBA Finals and await the winner of the Lakers and Clippers series. The Milwaukee Bucks have only lost one contest in this entire playoff run. Can Kawhi and Paul George overcome this 8-point deficit at halftime to get back and get the win? Let's head back to the Staples Center to find out.
So glad to have you with us here as we bring you more action from courtside at Game 5. It's been a clinic out there by James.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
Yeah, the offense looks crisp, and guys are hitting their shots.
And for those of you just tuning in, thanks for being with us. The second half of this game still to play. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. Setting the floor for the Clippers, we've got Marcus Morris, Patrick Beverley out there with Paul George. Then there's Kawhi Leonard, and it's Zubats in at the five, roaming the paint.
Specialty of the teams. I mean, he's a high activity guy. He's opportunistic on the offensive glass.
Here's Leonard. Great D that time from Davis.
Fantastic positioning there to contest that one.
From textbook defense. I mean, it took a good angle to the shooter and bothered the release.
A nice shot by LeBron.
I like to say I'm blown away, but honestly, with LeBron, a game like this, it's just par for the course.
Beverly finds George. Back to Beverly. Five to shoot. Ball's knocked loose. The Clippers need to get off a shot. And here's Morris for three. Hits the three-point bomb.
And even when the D is all up and in on Morris, he nails the shot. Great job at keeping his eyes on the basket.
Bradley against Beverly. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Lakers shooting their sixth and seventh free throw attempts tonight. And free throw good from Avery Bradley. Both free throws good from Avery Bradley. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. A three from Leonard, buries it from three-point range. Leonard's got 21 in the game.
But the D didn't do a good enough job on him. He could be an ace when he gets a good look at three.
McGee, the pass to LeBron. Back to McGee. Outside, Green. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Nice and steady so far in the second half. They're 3 for 4.
Clippers trail by 11. And here's George. He's got 13. Good D by LeBron.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Oh, just fantastic defense from Morris, getting right in the face of the shooter and coming up with a rejection.
And giving up some inches inside, but makes up for it with an aggressive style.
Yeah, it's the attack mindset. I mean, that helped him prevail right there. Sometimes you just got to go with your gut.
The Clippers have only one missed free throw. They've had 5 attempts and made 4 of them.
Left side.
Free throw drops for Leonard. Now James. He's got 20. With the shot. It's hauled in by Zubats. Zubats has got his 6th rebound on the night. And it's George finishing it off.
Well, doesn't have to break stride at all thanks to the money lead pass.
And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Bradley with the ball. He's got 11. Here's Davis. In for his 7th make in 14 tries.
Just so resourceful as a player. Davis gets the job done inside in all sorts of ways. And that's one of them right there, crashing the offensive glass, getting that second chance bucket.
It's Bradley on the wing. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. James has got 3 assists tonight.
You know, not necessarily what you're looking for, but still able to convert.
Here's Beverly. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up.
Well, and Beverly's a guy who loves physical contact. He really tries his best to absorb the contact on his shots to draw these fouls.
It's his first trip to the line. The first one falls. Free throws good from Beverly.
Well, in overtime, Beverly has established himself as just a defensive specialist, juggernaut, an absolute pest who plays his tail off on both ends of the floor.
James in the post, defended by George. McGee with no one around, off target with his 3.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
George looking around and stolen by LeBron. And Green now, top of the key. Count it, good. Green's got 5 points so far.
And James is great at staying alert on defense, pouncing on any opportunity he sees to swipe the ball.
And Beverly kicks to Zubats. Back to Beverly. Lock at 6. Zubats against McGee. McGee with the block. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. Deion Waiters checked in for Bradley. And the Clippers making a change here as well. Williams has checked in. Left side, Waiters. Takes a three. And the Lakers get it back. Here's McGee. Good, nice job down low. McGee's got the lead up to 12 now for the Lakers.
This is where McGee's coaches and teammates want him to shoot from. They know he can do damage in there with his hops.
And stolen by LeBron. And the dunk by James.
Great teamwork, punctuated by a strong finish.
Perfect example of how to run the break the right way and get a great look.
To the inside, Leonard, and Davis sends it back.
He's got that huge wingspan, and boy, does he use it well on the defensive end. If Davis is within shouting distance of the shooter, there's a good chance he'll get a hand on it.
Here's LeBron, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. James has got 24 points.
In the mid-range, rarely the hallmark of efficiency in today's NBA, but it is on point tonight.
And the Clippers call time here. You look at James, what a contribution.
And he's been taking it to the rack all game, and they have been able to contain him. They have to put up better fight on the inside.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions right now. They need a basket.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Zubac. Harrell, he's checked in for the Clippers. Here's the Lakers with the ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Harrell against McGee. Back to James. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. And Beverly kicks to Leonard.
Over Davis.
And again, no good by the Clippers.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look. They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Here's Leonard. Hands the 12-footer. Leonard's got 8 points here in this quarter.
Yeah, and from mid-range, Leonard's jump shot is money. It doesn't matter if it's off the dribble or catch and shoot. He never loses his touch.
Shot's good by Waiters.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for the Clippers. They trail by 16. And Davis sends it back. LeBron against Morris. Now here's Waiters. Back to LeBron. Kicks it to Waiters. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. LeBron's got 6 assists now in the game.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Outside Leonard. Back to Harrell. And Harrell slams it in.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher. Waiters outside. Back to James. Shoots from 8. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. It's on Kawhi Leonard.
When James gets you in the air, I mean, you're toast. He's superb at going right into the contact.
This is his second trip to the line in this one. Free throw good, LeBron. Markieff Morris is checked in for the Lakers. And a switch here also for the Clippers. Jackson, he's checked in for Patrick Beverley.
so he picks up just one from the line that time. Clippers trail by 18. Leonard, the pass to Williams. Back to Leonard. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
Ooh, he put a little extra on that one.
He does. He doesn't usually finish soft either. Obviously, he can when necessary, but not that time. Waiters surveying the D. Tipped away. Williams with the steal. And here comes Jackson leading the fast break. And he gets the bucket.
Oh, man. And Jackson is just incredibly fast in transition. It's just the defense's worst nightmare when he's leaking out in the open floor.
James against Harrell. Green in the post. And the ball's tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. So it's the Clippers now. Clippers trail by 14. Here's Leonard. And he makes that one. Leonard's got 30.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
Yeah, that's why he's hot. He's playing with a lot of confidence. That's why they're going to him with such consistency.
Outside, Green. He dishes it to Waiters. Five on the clock. But he recovers it.
Oh, he's got a role in this quarter, taking it on himself to guide their offense.
The Clippers shooting it beautifully here in the third, 56% from the field. Green against Jackson. He kicks it to Harrell. Shot on the way. Bank shot. No good.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in cracking this huge lead.
And there's the pass to LeBron. It's stolen by Morris. On the wing, Williams. That shot missing. So the Lakers will take it the other way. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Deflects the pass. 1:15 left to play in the third. That shot is off. Excellent D there from Waiters. Green kicks to Morris. James outside. Right at the free throw line, and he hits the jump shot. James has got 9 points here in the second half.
LeBron taking what's offered from mid-range throughout his career. He's all about the best shot of him.
And there's the call on James. And that'll be his third foul so far. The Lakers making a switch here. Rondo's checked in. Paul George, he's checked in for the Clippers. Andre Shamet comes in for Lou Williams. There's 42 seconds left here in the third quarter. And Harrell slams it in.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope. He, his only concern right now is getting the points on the board. And I don't mean style points. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Leonard against Rondo. Outside Jackson. Back to Leonard. Over Rondo. Count it, and the Laker lead has been cut down to just 12 points on the bucket from Leonard.
But he's just not going to give up. I mean, if he has to do it all by himself, that's what he's going to do.
Two on the clock. That shot, no good. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. They've had such great ball movement and shot selection, and it's led to a terrific field goal percentage. And we'll be back with you shortly.
So three quarters in the books and the Lakers have widened their lead now to 12 points. While it certainly isn't over, the Lakers have done a good job of keeping the Clippers at arm's length all game. It's going to take a great effort from Kawhi Leonard and Paul George to lead their team back, but the NBA is a game of runs, and you just never know what's going to happen. We appreciate you tuning into our coverage of the Western Conference Finals, and I'll be back after the game to recap all of tonight's action and to preview Game 6. We'll see you then.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. Clippers trail by 12. At the 2 and the 3, it's Bradley and Green. Anthony Davis is out there with Morris. And it's Rondo in at the 1. That's who's in the game for the Lakers. Offensive rebound, Harrell. And Harrell slams it in.
And how about the offensive rebound with a little extra punch on the putback?
You're right, Greg. As they look to trim the deficit, could we see them send a few more bodies to the boards from here on out? Maybe, just maybe. And it's Davis missing. And so it's Jackson who brings it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. It's stolen by Rondo. Pass to Davis. Fader on the way. The Clippers grab the miss. George has got rebound number 8 now on the night. Here's Harrell, and Harrell slams it in.
And although an undersized center, more than making up for it with some serious hops.
Rondo passes to Morris. Back to Rondo. Morris right side. Shoots over Shamet. Morris dishes to Davis, and he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
Yeah, and that's what you love about him. He shows no mercy, even with a comfortable lead.
That one misses for Davis. Clippers trail by 10. Jackson in the corner. And Harrell slams it in.
There you see why you want the ball in Jackson's hands as much as possible. He can clearly set the table.
Outside Rondo. Pass to Bradley. And it's sent back by Leonard.
And a sensational individual defender. Leonard will lock you down. Rejections are just part of the package he brings on the defensive end. Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
Morris outside. Just 5 to shoot. And it's Davis missing.
And smothered him on that mid-range attempt.
Well, that's how you play it. He does a good job of getting into the shooter's airspace.
And here's George for 3. That's good, and it's Jackson with the assist that time. Jackson's got 4 assists now tonight. Boats it up for Davis. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
Yeah, and Rondo just working the ball around there. He loves finding his teammates when they're open in the sweet spot.
It's good. George has got 5 points in the quarter.
And that's right in his wheelhouse, looking to make an impact when it counts.
Well, Greg, this is why they go to him in these spots. I mean, they trust his judgment and ability to score down the stretch.
And that one's good by Davis.
Oh, a little touch of class there at the end of the play as he was able to convert on the finger roll.
Look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. George, no good. Lakers leading by 7. Here's Rondo. Great D that time from Harrell.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
Excellent D, avoiding fouling and got in the perfect position to alter the shot.
Back to George. George, double team. Back to Harrell. Deep. And it's Shamet missing.
and they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus five in that category.
Rondo scanning the floor. Morris passes to Davis. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's on Kawhi Leonard.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
That one falls for Davis. JaVale McGee's checked in for Morris. The Clippers also making some changes. Ivica Zubac has checked in for Landry Shamet. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Jackson. And both free throws good for Davis. And so Beverly will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter, and it's Rajon Rondo with the foul. That's his first foul. Bradley against George. Leonard looking around. Here's Harrell. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Harrell's got 12 points here in the second half.
Oh, it's all about the assist on that play. He puts it in the perfect spot.
Outside, Green, pass to Davis. Yep, it counts. Davis has got 10 points in the quarter.
He gets it to him off the bounce pass and gets the assist.
Clippers trail by 9. And here's Beverly. Got it. Good job in the low post.
Even when contact comes Beverly's way, I mean, he's a pro at finishing, absorbing it so well on these shots.
Davis, the pass to Bradley. Just 5 on the clock. From deep, Green. And another 3 for the Lakers.
He's just stretching them out. The defense has got to do a better job of staying attached to him.
Yeah, I mean, that's not a guy you can leave alone. Not if you have any hope of closing the gap.
Makes up for a lack of speed with just tremendous effort and hustle on that play.
Rondo against Beverly. The pass to Davis. Outside for Rondo. To Davis. And that's going to be too many steps. Gets the whistle on the travel. James checked in for the Lakers. Morris is checked in for the Clippers. Clippers trail by 8. Outside Leonard. McGee with the block. Passes it to George. Goes back up. Count that one. George has got 7 points for the quarter.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Pass to James. Stolen by George. Inside, here's Leonard, and Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
That's a stomach punch, guys. Turn it over and give him a free run to the bucket.
Oh, you're so right. No question who has the momentum now.
Oh, exactly right. Momentum shifting plays like that can change the tone of the game.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. Lakers leading by 6. Green left side. Back to LeBron. And he lobs it up toward the rim.
And a sharp pass to set up that high percentage shot in close.
The Clippers shooting at 44%, pretty reasonable. Leonard on the wing. He's guarded by Davis. And it's out of bounds. The Clippers able to retain possession here. Bradley against Beverly. Here's Leonard. Zubac, great positioning on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Pass to Davis. The pass to Bradley. That's tipped. Morris with the ball. Now guarded by Bradley. Beverly, the pass to Morris. Here's Davis. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. And he knocks down the first one. And both free throws good for Davis. Clippers trail by 8. Now George. Zubac in the post. McGee's there. Back to Zubac. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a three-point play.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
What's up?
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
And here's James. He'll bring it up for the Lakers. Outside Green. The drive by James. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. That one on George.
Now when James is attacking like this, it's sometimes overwhelming for the D, and they're forced to compromise.
And the first one at the line is good.
And they didn't shoot it very well from the line in the first half, but they've gotten much better since halftime, and it's helped them to secure the lead.
And both free throws, good for James. Clippers trail by 7. To the middle. Here's Leonard. Avery Bradley pulls it in. Bradley's got 6 rebounds in the game.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
And smother them on that mid-range attempt.
Well, that's how you play it. He does a good job of getting into the shooter's airspace.
It's George on the wing, guarded by McGee. Shot clock at 5. George, no good.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
Excellent D, avoiding fouling and got in the perfect position to alter the shot.
And you can see the defense broke down there, allowing him to get all the way to the hoop.
Zubac kicks to Leonard. Go, passes it to Morris. No good on that one. James with some nice D. Over in the corner, Green. A three-pointer, no good. Clippers trail by 9. Leonard, the pass to Morris. Here's Zubats. McGee with the block. James with it. Now here's Davis. Back to James. The shot's good. And now it's an 11-point Laker lead.
Coming off the screen, LeBron showing the poise. He runs this play time and time and time again.
The three from George. Anthony Davis grabs the miss.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
Yeah, he just hit a rough patch. He's trying to climb out of it, but he hasn't been successful.
And every miss finds its way to his hands. Well, what an impressive performance.
Yeah, Greg, and it's more than just being in the right place at the right time. I mean, he's been active and aggressive. That's just the product of good pass work. I mean, nice team basketball right there.
Kicks it to LeBron. Back to Davis. It's hauled in by the Clippers.
Jesus, surprises anyone with that miss. When he's left alone like that, you can usually count it.
And stolen by James. And so the Lakers take the win. This was a pivotal game in the series so far, and they were able to keep their heads straight, get the job done, and take the all-important 3-2 lead.
Now they can breathe just a little bit easier, they're just one win away from closing this thing out. Had they lost this game, the pressure on them would have been huge. Oh,
just gigantic, you're right. That concludes this broadcast of the Western Conference Finals. For Chris Webber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
So the Lakers hold off the Clippers in the fourth quarter and take the 3-2 series lead here in the Western Conference Finals. Hank Buckets back to recap the game. The Lakers in the driver's seat now, just one game away from clinching their berth to the NBA Finals and the right to take on the Milwaukee Bucks. Milwaukee stamped their ticket by taking out the Boston Celtics in 5. Giannis and company waiting in the wings to see who their opponent will be when the NBA Finals get underway. Looking at tonight's stats, let's go ahead and check the box scores for both teams. For the victorious Lakers, it was LeBron James leading the way with 33 points, Anthony Davis right behind him with 30. With those 10 boards, Anthony Davis also records a double-double. Speaking of double-doubles, that's exactly what Kawhi Leonard had with 34 points and 11 rebounds. PG-13 finished the game with 22 points of his own. So that's going to pretty much wrap up tonight's coverage of the Western Conference Finals. We look forward to Game 6 here on SGU Sports Network. Also, don't forget the continuous Major League Baseball coverage here on SGU Sports Network as we bring you 4 spotlighted games a day in the simulated MLB season. Make sure to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you don't miss a thing. For the entire SGU Sports Network team, I'm Hank Buckets. We'll see you at our next broadcast. We'll be right back.